Jesus, the body of Christ in God. Amen. We pray that by His Solomon wisdom, He will receive the wisdom. Lord, Your word says in John 34, verse 9, that when Moses laid his hands on Joshua, you received the spirit of wisdom. Even as your apostles have laid hands on your son, we ask for a fresh infusion of wisdom to deal with the affairs of this nation. We pray for insight. We pray for foresight. We pray that He closes ears to negative things and criticisms that will not yield fruit. We ask that You grant Him the tongue of the learned, and You cause Him to be bold as the lion, and not turn away from any. We ask Your word of defense for His family. Protect His wife. Let her be a positive influence in His life. We pray for His children. Let this new role of their father not make them estranged from You, and not make them a situation to the body of Christ, but instead, let it be a time where You would sustain them to be examples and blessings to this nation. We pray for strength and health and physical vitality like Your servant has never known before. From today, Lord, let Him be recognized by the nation, because You've put new honor upon Him. Thank You, Lord. And when we ask, we receive. In Jesus' name, we call it done. Amen.
May the Lord who has crowned you with His glory continue to be with you. And may He grant you wisdom as you execute your duties as a secretary, the general secretary of Ghana, Pentecostal, and Charismatic Council. Amen.
Vineyard. I'm also grateful to the search committee led by the Right Reverend Sam Kuramchi Ankara, the National Executive Council led by our indefatigable President Apostle Professor Opoku Onyinah, and the National Delegates Conference for the trust reposed in me in selecting, nominating, and conferring my nomination as the General Secretary of the Ghana Pentecostal and Charismatic Council. I'm grateful to the leadership and entire membership of the Global Evangelical Church for serving as a nurturing and grooming ground where the Lord prepared me for today. I want to single out for special mention our immediate past moderator, the very Reverend Dr. E.K. Tete, the current moderator, the Snod Clerk, for their support through the entire process of nomination and my appointment. I promise by the grace of the Almighty God not to disappoint them. I also want to salute all my predecessors, especially the outgoing secretary, the general secretary, for their hard work in laying a solid foundation for the council upon which I have the privilege of continuing to build. I promise again by the grace of the Almighty God to build diligently so that the council may move on to higher ground. I intend to consult them every now and then so as to tap into their rich experiences to move the council forward. I cannot forget the staff of the secretariat, both past and present, who have also contributed in their own unique way to bringing the council this far. And I hope I can count on their support to move the council further forward. I'm grateful to my family, both nuclear and extended, for their support. And I want to bring up for special mention my dear and very beautiful wife, Gloria, for her unflinching support over the years. She has stood by me through thick and thin. She has been my helper, my counselor, and my prayer support all these years. And I thank her for her promise to continue to stand by me in the years ahead. I also want to thank our children for their support and for being good children. They are not giving me much problems. I want to thank also my elder brother, Mr. George Barrigah, and his wife who are here. They saw me through my education. And in all humility, and I hope I can count also on the supportful counsel and cooperation of all, so that together we can move the council to greater heights. Apostle President, I want to end by again saluting my dear brother, the outgoing General Secretary, Apostle Samuel Entry, and your wife, Margaret, for 8 years of dedicated and selfless service to the council. I wish you well in your next assignment. I thought you would have taken a sabbatical leave, but you are moving into ministry again as the area head of the tabernacle of the Church of Pentecost. May the Lord strengthen you in that assignment. Not only the Ghana Pentecostal and Charismatic Council, long live our dear nation, God. Thank you, and God bless you all.